TECHNI comes from the Greek meaning art, craft, skill, and shows up in dozens of English words. 这两个来自于希腊语，就这个词，意思是艺术、工艺和技术，出现在许多的英文单词中。Some, such as technique, technology, and technique, have long been familiar. 就这些词，我们都很熟悉。技术的技术，什么工艺啊？都很熟悉。Others, such as techno, were only coined in the current computer age, which has also seen the new cut-down terms techno. But technopop, the electronic dance music and tech for technician or technology. 其他的词，例如这个惊悚的意思，科技惊悚的，出现在计算机时代创造出来的。这个词也有新的缩略词，比如说这样写，这都是电子舞曲和这个词。是这两个词的一个简写的一个形式，技工或者是技术。Technocrat, a scientist or technical expert with power in politics or industry. 科学家或者是技术的专家，在什么？在政治或者是行业，所以我们翻译成技术专家的官员。The new president, a great fan of science, had surrounded himself with an impressive team of technocrat. 这个新任总统是科技迷，周围围绕的技术官员数量惊人。In 1919, W.H. Smith coined the term technocracy to mean basically management of society by technical experts. 1919年，史密斯创造了这个词，一文意思是技术专家管理社会，就通过技术专家来管理这个社会。Technocracy grew into a movement during the Great Depression of the 1930s when politicians and financial institutions were being blamed for the economic disaster, and fans of technocracy claim that letting technical experts manage the country would be a great improvement. 技术专家管理社会出现在20世纪的30年代，就这个词成为一个运动，在20世纪的30年代的大衰退时期，政治家和金融机构受到责备，因为这次的灾难。然后呢，技术爱好者声称让技术专家管理这个国家会有很大的进步。 They also suggested that dollars could be replaced by energy certificates representing energy units called ERGs. 他们也声称美元应该被这个替代，这是什么呢？能源证书来替代，代表的是能源单位的这个词。 Today, technocratic are still popular words for experts with a highly rational and scientific approach to public policy issues. 今天这两个词依然是受到这样的专家的欢迎的词。什么样的一个专家呢？对于公共政策问题有着高度的合理和科学处理方法的这专家的欢迎。But these experts are not always the best politicians, and when a terrific technological solution to a problem is opposed by a powerful group or industry, lawmakers find it easier to just ignore it. 但是呢，这些专家并不总是最好的政治家。当一个出色的解决问题的技术方法受到很强的群体或者行业反对的时候，立法人员发现忽略它更容易一些。Technophobe, one who fears or dislikes advanced technology or complex devices, and especially computers. 就这个人害怕或者不喜欢先进的技术或者是复杂的设备，尤其是指电脑，所以它指的是先进技术恐惧者或者是电脑恐惧者，害怕电脑。 The new employee was a middle-aged technophobe who seemed startled every time a new page popped out on her computer screen. 新的这名员工是个中年人，害怕先进技术，他都会大吃一惊，每一次新的网页跳出来，电脑屏幕跳出新的页面的时候，他都会大吃一惊。The condition known as technophobia got its name around 1965, though its synonym, LADA, had been around for a long time, and since then, we have been flooded with electronic gadgetry. 就这种病被称为 technophobia, 在1965年左右就有了的这个名字，尽管在很久以前它的同义词 LADA 就已经出现了。从此以后，我们有大量的电子的机器， 小机器的意思，就到处都是啊，就应接不暇。But even today, few people actually understand any electrical technology more complicated than a light bulb. So there's still plenty of technophobia around. 但是，直至今天，很少有人对哪个电子技术的了解超过对灯泡的了解。所以呢，有大量的电子先进技术的恐惧症。And it isn't limited to computer users. 这不仅仅局限于电脑使用者。Atomic bomb made technophobes out of millions of people. And since human caused climate change has been the result of technology, it's not surprising that it too has produced a technophobic response. 原子弹的爆炸使得无数的人成了先进技术的恐惧者，因为人类引起的气候的变化是技术的结果，就是由技术造成的，也没有什么好奇怪的，也引发了先进技术恐惧症的反应。 But if technology turns out to be part of a solution, maybe that will change. 但是呢，技术可以部分的解决上述问题，也许会有变化。